What's going on, my MPC family? This is Beats by Jay Black. I'm sorry I had to hit you with my YouTube intro. But how you guys feeling? I'm excited. We got the new MPC Live 2. That thing just kind of snuck up on us. I didn't know it was happening. I know I said something in a previous video about the rumors, but I promise you, I really didn't know. Lo and behold, a couple weeks later, it really is here. And I'm really happy because Akai actually sent this to me. Now, some of you guys won't believe this, but this is the first MPC that they've ever sent me. All the MPCs you see in all my videos, I bought those straight up. So what's really dope about this is I feel like I'm in that step in my career now where it's like they seeing me. We moving. So without further ado, let's get straight to looking into the system. Now, this is not going to be a full review because honestly, just to be fair to you guys, I only had it for about 2 days. So we can just kind of do a quick comparison from this to the Live, just as far as physical, and also do a quick sound test too as well to see what it compares to. I'll compare it to my iPad and other little Bluetooth speakers and stuff like that I can find around the house, because surprisingly the speaker has a little bit of kick to it. It has some thump. I like the way it's cooking. Let's get straight into it. So found right on the back of it, everything is kind of the same, just like the MPC Live. We have the power button right here on the very left side in the back. Next to that, with the power jack where you were used to charge it. What's really nice is we do now have the RJ45, which is the Ethernet input, so we can use Ableton Link or other updates in the future that's going to use the Ethernet, which is going to be really cool. We have our lockdown. We do have our USB. Also, with our USB 3.0, we have two of those, which is really nice. Just like on the regular MPC Live, we have our MIDI in and MIDI outs back here. But just like on the MPC One, we actually get these 4 CV gate inputs. What's nice is if you have a splitter, you can actually make these into 8, just like on the MPC X. We have our SD card here. Of course, we have our inputs. This is my favorite for sampling. And you also have your red and white inputs if you want to connect an actual DJ turntable to the system too as well. Found with your ground wire that's located right next to it. We got your record volume, of course, to adjust that. And we have our outs. We have our left and right stereo outs with 4 routable extra ones. So now moving on to the last bit of I/O. These are the 2 new things here. So we have a speaker on switch that you can turn on and off to turn this big subwoofer off. So I'm sorry, not a subwoofer, this sound bar. And then we also have the headphone jack. Now, it's kind of a mixed bag with me and his headphone jack because I actually like the aux. And I'll tell you why in a little bit. It has to do with the iRig. But some people are actually going to respect this because I think this kind of creates longevity. Because I know there are some issues with the aux in the past with that going out. So, that's the back. That's covered. We can now look at the front of the model. So, the biggest thing you see this thing is this thing got a little chin on it. It got a little chin on it. It is heavier than the MPC Live. You do notice that, but not as a bad thing. If anything, it feels a little bit more sturdier. When you're putting this thing down on the desk and you're hitting pads, it gives you almost that same feel as if you're playing on an MPC X, just because of that weight. And also because I know this is a speaker, but obviously your hand is, your wrist is gonna rest on this. It's gonna happen. It's nice to kind of have that wrist rest too. And it's still portable, still battery powered, everything's still the same. So starting from the front of the aisle, one of the biggest things that I love and I appreciate is the master volume being right there on the top of the console on the left side. That is game changer. I love having that control right there at ease of use. Another game changer is adding more buttons to the unit. We didn't have the undo and a copy, I believe, but we now have the step sequencer, the time control, which is pretty dope. You have your mix button right there found, and also with the next sequence added to as well. So those are some extra buttons that they added. This thing is heavy. This thing is, I'm feeling it. I'm feeling it. I'm one arm in this thing as I'm doing a voiceover. So let me tell you why this speaker is a game changer for me. So as you know, I love to use the iRig. The iRig is one of my favorite recording devices that I use when I post on social media, and I have my beats coming out pretty decently clear. I'm using that. That's what I use. That's my secret. But one thing that you would need to do is you would need to route the iRig to your phone and then have another source of how you can hear, kind of like a monitor. And I didn't really like using the iRig, connecting another cable to the iRig so I can hear what's coming back, because one, it lead to more cables and you're risking on tugging and pulling, and I wanted to keep the set clean. So what's really nice about this is when I'm on the go is I can use the monitor on the front and still plug in my iRig, hear exactly what I have going on the outside surroundings or what I'm playing feeding in, but I know my audio is still feeding in and I don't need an extra Bluetooth speaker on the side for a reference or need headphones or anything like that. This right here is the reference. And like I said, when you guys hear this speaker, it's gonna surprise you. It sounds full. Like, it sounds full. I guess the biggest question that we all have is the longevity. How long are these speakers gonna last? I love to thump. You know, are these speakers going to withstand a couple years of these things being cranked up? And I know another question is, how does the speakers impact the battery? Does this really impact the battery a lot? Now, I've been using it for about 24 hours straight, and I can't really say I notice a difference. Now, with all fairness, my MPC Live batteries, I've worn those batteries out, so those batteries don't have the longest battery life. So this right here, compared to all those, is already a champ. But we're gonna know a little bit in the future, probably give me a month or so to really put this thing through the paste and to really see how long this battery or how long the Bluetooth speaker takes to drain it out. So that's the speaker. Everything else is pretty much the same. 2.8 is a beast. You still can include your SSD hard drive right here in the back, which is also a beauty. So what we can do before we wrap up is we can go ahead and do a quick sound test. All right, that was the quick sound test. Understand that you can't judge it off of phone, but you might can hear the clarity and what bass, what gains. You can kind of be the judge of that. For me, it's actually pretty surprising. This is the Jambox Drawbone. I had this in the family for like 5-6 years, and I still have it because this thing knocks, it punches. And I'm not saying this thing punches just as loud as this thing, but it's definitely something that I can set this to the side and use this comfortably without worrying about losing that pump, that fullness. So the speaker, A plus. But yo, I hope you guys like the initial review. I hope this helps out making any decisions on pre-orders or anything. I would say definitely pick it up. You wouldn't be wrong for going with the original Live, but this right here is the future. I think this is innovating to its full potential for the simple reason that I've always been thinking of having a speaker. Every time I looked at the side of this thing, I've always been thinking, what if they had a speaker here? What if this thing could knock? And they actually did that. So I'm here for it. I'm here for it. I know a lot of people are probably worried about the longevity and worried about that. Well, I can just say be careful with it. That being said, man, you guys have a good one. Let me know if you guys have any other questions or other things that you guys want to see or put this thing behind some tests. Other than that, man, you guys be easy. You guys have a great one. Peace.